Hachette Audio presents Ultra Longevity, written by Mark Liponis, MD, and read by Peter Johnson. The Ultra Longevity 8-day meal plan is included as a PDF file on the last CD.
Introduction. The legendary Spanish explorer Juan Ponce de Leon supposedly spent the year 1513 searching for the Fountain of Youth. He wasn't the first person to look. Stories of waters that restore youth to the aged have been popular throughout history. Such waters have been said to be located in Ethiopia, in distant Asia, in northern Europe, or many other places off the beaten path. For centuries, people have explored, but without any luck. After landing in the Americas, the Spanish began to hear numerous tales from indigenous peoples about a fountain that could make adults young once again. Excited at the prospect, they thought there was a strong chance these waters were located in what is now the state of Florida, or on the island of Bimini, just north of Cuba, which is where De Leon eventually sailed. He never did find the fountain there, but he did locate the Bahama Channel, the quickest route between Cuba and Europe. De Leon eventually was made a knight, and later governor of Florida. He died in 1521 at the relatively old age, for an explorer, of 61. De Leon's failure didn't stop countless other explorers, dreamers, alchemists, and adventurers from seeking a fountain of youth, whether in the form of water, a tonic, a pill, or anything else that would guarantee agelessness. No one, however, seemed to find it. Then there's Laura, one of my patients. Over the last decade, Laura has taken up and mastered both golf and tennis. Whenever she comes to Canyon Ranch, she manages to find a competitive game. She wasn't always so healthy, however. An asthmatic child, Laura visited the doctor frequently and was treated with shots of adrenaline numerous times, even as a young adult. And in her early 60s, she was diagnosed with breast cancer. She had a mastectomy. But now, Laura is in excellent health for someone her age, which is 81, or 20 years older than Ponce de Leon was when he died. In fact, Laura is 20 years younger than her chronological age. Her heart purrs like a tuned engine. Tests of the elasticity of her arteries and heart rate variability are perfect. Her blood tests are all better than normal and into the optimal range. Laura hasn't found the Fountain of Youth per se, but she is in on a secret that is helping her stay younger than everyone around her. What is that secret? Laura has learned how to live in harmony with her immune system. The theory guiding this new way of living stems from a growing body of research in a field that scientists and medical professionals are just beginning to understand: immunology, or the study of the immune system. What we are learning is that it isn't impossible, and in fact it might be quite probable, for humans to live to be well over 100 years old. Now you might say that you don't want to live to 100. Who wants to spend years sitting in a wheelchair in the bleak hall of a cold, unpleasant nursing home? Meanwhile, your joints are arthritic, your bones brittle, your arteries clogged, your brain foggy, your lung capacity shrunk, and your muscle strength diminished. Your heart can't pump properly. You feel tired, and you're so constipated that having a good day means having a bowel movement. Who wants to live to be 100 if the above is an accurate description of aging? But over the last few years, medical science has learned that all conditions just mentioned, all these terrible and painful signs of aging, are mainly caused by problems within the immune system. In other words, the part of the body that was meant to defend us, the immune system, is actually turning on us and causing us to age. The fact that the immune system can turn dangerous has been known for some time. For a few decades now, medical science has understood that certain diseases such as thyroid disease, multiple sclerosis, rheumatoid arthritis, ulcerative colitis, diabetes, and Crohn's disease are diseases caused by the immune system, or what are known as autoimmune diseases. These autoimmune diseases occur when the body is attacked by its own immune system. People who come down with autoimmune diseases tend to have highly overactive immune systems whose myriad weapons are attacking the body's own tissues instead of the various viruses and bacteria they are supposed to fight. Scientists are beginning to understand that it is not just a few diseases that can be chalked up to this immune system hyperactivity. It now appears that every disease of aging is associated with immune hyperactivity, and this hyperactivity is largely responsible for human aging itself. But just as we're realizing the nature of this medical issue, we are also starting to figure out ways to cope with it. This means that if you take the best possible care of your immune system and can prevent it from becoming overactive, you may well live to be more than 100 years old and be of healthy mind and body during every one of those years. In other words, instead of feeling terrible in a nursing home, you can, like Laura, spend your life outdoors playing tennis, indoors learning new skills, or enjoying time with your loved ones at any age. If you can enhance your immune system, you won't live forever, but you may live more than 100 years, be free from disease throughout your life, keep your brain sharp, be more physically fit, feel more energetic, be able to cope with stress, feel and stay younger than you ever imagined. Before you learn more about the immune system and its effects on your health, consider the following questions that touch on your lifestyle and your immune system. Do you need to lose 10 pounds? Carrying around extra weight is stressful, not just on your back and your joints, but on your immune system too. Besides causing you to be at higher risk for diseases such as diabetes, heart disease, and cancer, extra weight can also overstimulate your immune system. One of the best ways to measure the extent of immune activation is the C-reactive protein, CRP, blood test. The higher your CRP levels, the more active your immune system is. A March 2006 article in the Journal of the American Medical Association, JAMA, showed that overweight women were 8 to almost 10 times more likely to have a hyperactive immune system, as demonstrated by higher levels of CRP than among women of healthy weight, even if they were physically active. Studies on men show similar results. Do you smoke? Smoking is one guaranteed way to age your body faster. You know the effects: wrinkled skin, clogged arteries, emphysema, cancer, and impotence, to name just a few. But the most important reason to stop smoking is that it overstimulates the immune system, which in turn speeds up aging. A May 2005 study from the American Heart Journal revealed that smokers showed signs of high immune activation, including elevated CRP levels, as well as higher levels of macrophage-stimulating factors, which trigger our white blood cells to multiply, proliferate, and kill. We'll talk more about that later. Even secondhand smoke causes immune activation. A February 2004 study in the American Journal of Medicine showed that people exposed to secondhand smoke at least 3 days a week had higher white blood counts, as well as higher CRP levels, than people not so exposed. Do you live in a congested metropolitan area or city? Breathing in polluted air activates your immune system into a constant defense mode that ages your body prematurely. A February 2006 study in the American Journal of Respiratory and Critical Care Medicine measured the day-to-day variations in CRP levels against the daily air pollution index. The study showed that CRP levels rose significantly approximately 2 days after subjects were exposed to particulate air pollution. Have you broken a sweat exercising in the past 24 hours? Exercise helps deactivate the immune system in several ways. A report in the American Journal of Cardiology in January 2004 confirmed findings from research in 2002, published in Circulation and in Epidemiology, which showed an inverse relationship between exercise and CRP. Exercise lowers CRP levels. It's no surprise that exercise has been proven to prevent just about every disease and reduce the effects of aging. What was your birth weight? Research shows that smaller babies, 5.5 to 6 pounds, have prematurely aged immune systems, while larger babies, up to 9.5 pounds, lead longer lives with less disease. Lower birth weight has been linked to higher levels of CRP and immune activation in adult life. In the recent mid-span family study, a large-scale long-term survey conducted in Scotland, researchers found that in the range between 5.5 and 9.5 pounds, CRP levels in adults were inversely proportional to their birth weight, and that within that range every kilogram, 2.2 pounds, at birth meant 11% lower CRP levels in adulthood.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.